Hi. Welcome to another episode of Tech Quadrangle TV. In this episode, we'll be looking at Apple's most secretive project yet, Project Titan. A project tasked with the development of an Apple car, a self-driving car that is set to change the way we travel and no doubt give Tesla a run for his money. It's going to be exciting, so sit back, relax, and let's dive in. We are currently launching our channel with this giveaway prize. A brand new Pacific Blue iPhone 12 Pro. To win, simply subscribe to our channel, click the bell icon so you'll be notified once we drop fresh content, watch the whole video, and most importantly, make a meaningful comment. In addition, we are throwing in an extra $500 for grabs, just for this video. But this time it's for subscribers that comment meaningfully in the comment section below. To win, simply hit the subscribe button and watch the full video, then tell us what you think about the upcoming Apple car. A winner will be announced after 500 comments. Moving on. Apple has a reputation for designing groundbreaking products that disrupt an entire industry. They did it in 2001 with iPod, again in 2007 with iPhone, and this time, about to do it with the Apple car. According to the Allied Market Research Report, the global market for autonomous vehicles will be worth $557 billion by 2026. Apple knows this very well. In fact, Apple knows that the money lies not so much on selling the cars but monetizing the passengers' idle time with ads, on entertainment apps, AR and VR displays. An ecosystem that Apple currently excels in. Lately, Apple is striving so much to introduce another revolutionary product like the iPhone to the market, and Tim Cook, Apple's CEO, believes disrupting the automotive industry will do the magic. In October 2015, he stated, "It would seem like there will be massive change in that industry, massive change, you may not agree with that. That's what I think. We'll see what we do in the future. I do think that the industry is at an inflection point for massive change." Apple car has been Steve Jobs' dream since 2008. But with his failing health and the runaway success of iPhone 1, launched the previous year, he decided to shelve the idea and concentrate on the iPhone. However, in late 2014, Tim Cook approved Project Titan, a project set up to develop autonomous vehicle systems and car design. From inception, the project was assigned to Steve Zadisky, a former Ford engineer. Also on board was Johan Jungwirth, the former president and chief executive of Mercedes-Benz Research and Development North America. By February 2015, it was rumored that a substantial number of Apple employees were working on an electric car project, with Apple hiring new employees for the project from Tesla. Reports in February 2015 indicated that Apple had been offering incentives to Tesla employees to join the project. An Apple employee confirmed this when he emailed Business Insider suggesting that Apple is working on a project that would give Tesla a run for its money, and Tesla employees were jumping ship to work on a project at Apple that was too exciting to pass up. By 2016, rumors had spread over town that Apple is working on a self-driving car, prompting their future competitor Tesla CEO Elon Musk to say, "It's pretty hard to hide something if you hire over 1,000 engineers to do it." Apple continued its hiring spree in 2016, even going as far as convincing Apple retired senior hardware engineering executive Bob Mansfield to return and take over the Titan project following the departure of Zadisky in 2015. However, the hiring of Dan Dodge, the founder and former chief executive officer of QNX, BlackBerry's automotive software division, sparked the notion that Apple might be shifting emphasis from actual car manufacturing in Project Titan to prioritizing creating software for autonomous vehicles. This notion quickly died down in mid-April 2017, as word spread that Apple was permitted to test autonomous vehicles on California roads. In mid-June 2017, Tim Cook, in an interview with Bloomberg TV, said Apple was focusing on autonomous systems, but not necessarily leading to an actual Apple car product.
What we're focusing on, or what we've talked about focusing on publicly, is we're focusing on autonomous systems. And clearly one purpose of autonomous systems is self-driving cars. There are others. And we sort of see it as the mother of all AI projects.
Apple's registration of 27 self-driving cars with California's Department of Motor Vehicles in January 2018 further confirms that Apple is inching closer and closer to an Apple car. In May same year, the New York Times reported that Apple proposed partnership arrangement with the following leading auto manufacturers: BMW, Mercedes-Benz, Nissan, BYD, McLaren Automotive, and Volkswagen, but only Volkswagen agreed to the partnership. The partnership would see Apple and Volkswagen working together to produce an autonomous employee shuttle van based on VW's T6 Transporter. The design and technology behind Project Titan remained very much in flux, sources said, with Apple at one point considering using BMW's i3 as the basis for its Apple car. Apple and BMW have held talks about a potential partnership, though BMW reportedly ended talks with Apple over who might lead the project and own data. The design efforts of Apple have been kept under wraps for the most part. Aside from rumors which have even suggested Apple is creating an electric van, the only real indications so far of Apple's design direction have been patent applications. As recently as April of this year, for instance, Apple filed a patent for window tinting technology. The patent specifically refers to vehicles in the filing, which is for technology that can apparently vary the level of tint it is reasonable to assume on a windscreen or sunroof. Other patents that excited Apple fans relate to real-time alignment and calibration of automotive sensors, smart tech that can recognize landmarks, and even a new generation car door that can prevent the user from swinging it out into oncoming traffic or into the path of a passing cyclist. Of course, we all know that patents alone don't reveal the whole picture, and that the general appearance of the upcoming Apple car could differ from current patent illustrations. But most probably Apple's use of sleek lines as they do in other products could be reused in the Apple car. Rumors have it that the final design will feature wide swinging doors that eliminate the need for a permanent center door pillar, making openings even larger. And that the interior will make extensive use of AR and VR technology, in-screen displays, privacy lighting, and unique sunroof designs, among other features. What do you think the Apple car will look like? Do let me know in the comments below. In 2017, Apple was granted a permit from the California Department of Motor Vehicles, otherwise known as California DMV, to test self-driving vehicles on public roads. It would appear the company was merely testing self-driving software embedded in a fleet of Lexus SUVs reportedly leased from Hertz. These SUVs and their conspicuous roof camera arrays were spotted by eagle-eyed Apple fans around on the streets of Cupertino, where Apple headquarters are based. As of April 2019, Apple had increased its number of testing fleets with California DMV to 69 vehicles and 110 drivers. By 2018, Apple had started working with VW on a self-driving shuttle testbed. The shuttle test will apparently carry Apple employees between Silicon Valley offices, with the Palo Alto to Infinite Loop route, hence giving the test scheme the name PAIL, which is short for Palo Alto to Infinite Loop. It is unknown when the vehicles will hit the road, but it is likely to be a welcome addition for employees working at the Apple Park campus. VW will be providing T6 Transporter vans, and Apple is said to be providing autonomous driving technology. The vehicles would be outfitted with specialized dashboards and seats, with further modifications to onboard computers, sensors, and an electric battery. In June 2019, Apple bought Drive.ai, a startup that led pilot programs of autonomous vehicles in the state of Texas. Despite the fact that Drive.ai has technically ceased operations, the purchase bought Apple dozens of employees from the company, along with the startup's cars and other unspecified assets. While terms of the deal were not revealed, Drive.ai was valued at approximately $200 million in 2017, with the purchase price possibly within that ballpark. On the investment side, Apple has sunk a whopping $1 billion into the Chinese ride-hailing service, Didi. Analysts in the know claim Didi store of driving data could be highly valuable to any Apple autonomous car project, since road data is one area where Project Titan clearly lags a long way behind Tesla. Didi incidentally merged with Uber's Chinese operation, adding substantial value to the Apple stake. In addition, a July 2017 report hinted that Apple was working with a Chinese firm, Contemporary Amperex Technology, with the intent to research and develop a new generation of car batteries. Both companies have kept a tight lip on their working relationship. It hasn't all been rosy at Project Titan. The project had experienced its fair share of crisis, especially with human resources. One of the project's early leaders, Steve Zadisky, allegedly left the company in 2015 under some shady clouds and was replaced by Tesla's vice president of vehicle engineering, Chris Porritt. In July 2016, longtime Apple executive Bob Mansfield was rumored to be in charge on a part-time basis after the senior vice president of hardware engineering, Dan Riccio, was given control of the project. In general, hundreds of people on the Project Titan team have either left on their own or been reassigned or cut following a crisis of confidence about the project's direction in 2016. However, one big hire that came in 2016 was Porsche's race program lead Alexander Hitzinger. While at Porsche, Hitzinger returned the company to endurance racing and assisted in the development of the 919 hybrid sports car. Hitzinger's command led the company to Le Mans and Endurance Racing World Championships in 2015 and 2016. In August 2017, Apple was reported to be hiring more staff for its self-driving project. The report from Business Insider cited a source familiar with Apple's technology and that of other similar self-driving platforms, with the new hires said to be focused on people who have experience in producing autonomous car software. A report at the end of the same month claimed Apple had lost 17 engineers from its automotive projects to the self-driving startup Zoox. The engineers were previously picked up by Apple from traditional carmakers and include employees specializing in braking, suspension, and other mechanical automotive systems. In August 2018, Doug Field, formerly the vice president of Mac hardware engineering at Apple, was hired back to the company following a five-year stint at Tesla. By December that year, Tesla senior designer Andrew Kim had started work for Apple. Kim had worked on interior design for vehicles while at Tesla, including a focus on the dashboard layout. And March 2019 saw the hiring of Michael Schwekutsch at Apple. Previously an engineering vice president at Tesla, Schwekutsch has an extensive history in powertrain development, which strongly suggests car designs are still a focus of Project Titan. In July 2018, former Apple employee Xia Lang Zhang pleaded not guilty to accusations of trade theft. Specifically, the theft of a 25-page schematic of a circuit board designed for use in autonomous vehicles. Zhang was a member of the Project Titan compute team. Apple's security team discovered unusual download activity involving confidential files when Zhang handed in company-issued tools as he was leaving, with the intention of moving to Guangzhou to take up a position at Chinese electric car startup X Motors. Under questioning, Zhang initially denied the allegations, but later admitted to taking two circuit boards and a Linux server, as well as airdropping files from company computers to his wife's notebook. A second employee, Jishong Chen, was arrested in January 2019. He was found to have taken photographs of a secret work area and hoarding manuals, diagrams, and schematics on the project. Chen had applied for a job at a Chinese self-driving technology company in what appeared to be another case of trade theft. In December 2019, Apple representatives appeared in federal court to ensure the two employees were closely monitored, with the argument they both posed flight risks. Apple Car may be Apple's biggest undertaking yet, and its worst-kept secret. Announcements surrounding the project should occur sometime in the next few years. Top Apple analyst, Ming-Chi Kuo, proposed in August 2018 that Apple will create a consumer product under Project Titan by as early as 2023, with the Apple Car launch window stretching as far as into 2025. There was no indication as to how the dates were determined by Kuo, but he wrote he expects Apple to take advantage of tectonic shifts in the automotive market. By leveraging potentially huge replacement demands emerging in the sector due to the introduction of new technologies, Kuo believes Apple can take advantage of a car market that is ripe for change, in a similar way to how the smartphone market existed before the iPhone. On the price, Apple is expected to keep in line with its competition. And this would now be the likes of Tesla. The current Model 3 Tesla starts at $35,000, so expect a similar price range for Apple's first standard car. Rumor has it that the upcoming Apple car will start at $55,000. To all the Apple fans and electric vehicle lovers out there, are you ready to part with $55,000 for an Apple car upon release? Do let me know in the comments below. I look forward to reading all your comments. And that's all we have for now on the upcoming Apple Car. If we do get any more news, of course, we will definitely share it with you. Don't forget to click the like button if you like this video, and of course to enjoy more technology content like this and some tech reviews, consider subscribing to our channel. And until our next episode, whatever you're up to in the next hour ahead, do it with passion or not at all. Thanks for watching.